Two decades ago, 10 very, very well-known IT professionals from India decided to meet at Bangalore. But this IT professionals were so popular that it was certain that the meeting was going to create a buzz. So they decided to drive all the way from Bangalore to a city on east coast of India known as Vizag. And this road trip of 1000 kilometers became foundation of India's one of the topmost company. Hey guys, welcome to When to Read What. And I have just completed reading The High Performance Entrepreneur written by Subrata Bagchi, who is also co-founder of India's one of the topmost leading IT company, Mindtree. And reading this book for me was just like taking some one-on-one advice from India's one of the topmost business gurus. And in this book, Subrata sir has written all the knowledge and the wisdom which he has gained during his endeavor in IT industry. So here are, according to me, the top three situations in which an entrepreneur usually finds herself, and also top three advices which Subrata sir has given via this book. So now coming to the first situation, which is, am I ready to become an entrepreneur? Well, this might sound like the most basic question, but according to me, here is where a true entrepreneur is born. And I was absolutely dumbstruck as I was reading this part of the book, as it is the very first chapter, and in it, Subrata sir has mentioned various reasons and examples when an entrepreneur thinks that he or she is ready to begin, but he or she is not. Though Subrata sir has mentioned many reasons and examples, one particular reason got stuck in my head. So let us begin with the example first. An young electronics engineer, let us call him Mr. A, along with two of his friends came to meet Subrata sir and discuss his business idea with him. So after listening to his business idea, Subrata sir, being from the IT background, told him that he was not an authority on that subject and that he should go and seek someone much more informed. So this is how the meeting was concluded, and the trio got up to leave the room. And that is when Mr. A stopped and he turned towards Subrata sir and asked, assuming that I gave idea a try and I failed, do you think you could hire me at Mindtree? And Subrata sir was shocked looking at the poor resiliency and the poor integrity of this man. His collaborators were standing right over there. And he didn't even feel ashamed while trying to strike a private deal for his own safety net. So, was he ready to become an entrepreneur? No, he was not, and probably never would be. Now, coming to the second most important situation, which is whether I am adding value to the society or not. So, irrespective of what an entrepreneur does, he or she should always add value to the society. And one of the biggest problems faced here is that how to know that he or she is adding value to the society or not. So for that, in the book, Subrata sir has given a potential solution using which an entrepreneur could know that whether he or she is adding value to the society or not. And the solution is defining the DNA of your company, your mission, vision, and your values. And if an entrepreneur is able to define these four terms clearly, then it is highly possible that he or she is adding value to the society. So now starting off with the DNA. So DNA stands for uniqueness of the company, or why should your organization or your company should exist in the first place. So in the book, Subrata sir has explained this concept with the help of Mindtree's example. But here, I'm going to explain it with the help of When to Read What's example. So the DNA of When to Read What is, we inform people when to read which book in a particular situation. So to explain it in a crude sense, it is just the same way as when a doctor or a physician prescribes a medicine at a particular time, usually after dinner or before dinner, etc. So is it like that if you take that particular medicine at any other time, then it won't have its effect? No, it will surely have its effect. But if you want to optimize the effect of that particular medicine, then you will have to take it at the prescribed time. So here we work on the same analogy. And Here, instead of medicines, we prescribe books. So now coming to the second point, which is mission. So mission is what you want to achieve. So the mission of When to Read What is, we believe that there is always a best time to read a book, and we want to inform about that best particular time to the society as soon as possible. Now coming to vision. So vision consists of intermediate, measurable and time-oriented goals, and one must be very much clear about his or her goals. However, vision is something which keeps on changing according to time and situation. So the vision of When to Read What is, we want to inform society about 500 books in an year along with the best particular time to read them. But logically speaking, it is very difficult for one or two guys to read 500 books in an year. So here we have came up with a new idea. So here we have decided to create an Instagram handle of When to Read What, where you can share your experiences regarding a particular book and how that particular book helped you. And then we will be sharing your experiences on our Instagram handle so that maximum people could benefit from it. Now coming to fourth and last point, which is values. So values is something which you define it for yourself and for your organization. So if you guys want to know the values which I have defined for When to Read What, then you can go on our Instagram handle and check the first post in which I have mentioned all the values of When to Read What, and I have also explained it how I reached that point. And I have also mentioned the link of our Instagram handle in the descriptions down below. So please do check it out. But before that, let us get to the third and the most important situation of this video. Now coming to the third and the most important situation, which is when things don't work out and it seems like that the startup is going to fail. So in this part of the book, Subrata sir has explained at least 5 to 6 different kind of results due to which a startup might fail. And here all the reasons are important, but here are, according to me, top 2 reasons due to which almost every other startup fails. So coming to the first reason, which is relationship cracks between the founders. So in this part, what I liked the most was that Subrata sir went on to explain the difference between friendship and a business partner. Because it is highly likely that when you start your own startup, your good friend is going to become your business partner. And this is when one might feel awkward while trying to discuss some critical issues like money management, management of the company, finances, expenses, etc. And this lack of communication might lead to a crack in the founding team. And this is also the single most valuable advice we as When to Read What has received via this book. Now coming to second most important reason, which is funding. So when a company starts to grow, it requires funding in order to expand. So if the founding team isn't able to raise the capital from the venture capitalist or financial institute, then it might lead to financial suicide of the company. So to avoid it, Subrata sir has mentioned that the founding team should have at least 3 to 5 years of roadmap planned ahead. And also the founding team should raise money well before their reserves get exhausted. So I hope you guys have got a good idea of what this book is all about. So if you're someone who is planning on to start your own startup or has already begun your startup, then this book is a good read for you guys, because it tells you about the difficulties which you will encounter in your endeavor, and it also provides the potential solutions to your problem. And this book can be a best read for businessman and entrepreneur, irrespective of whether you are a beginner, amateur or a professional. Because it happens many times that we as an entrepreneur run into a wall of problems which seems almost impossible to counter. And it is highly likely that this book will guide you in the right direction and you will find a solution of your problem. And if you are someone who is planning to start his own startup in the IT sector of India, then this book is a must read for you guys. Because in the book, Subrata sir has mentioned all of his knowledge and the wisdom which he has gained in his endeavor in IT industry of India. Though Subrata sir has mentioned at least 5 to 6 kind of different reasons. पंछी को हटा रे, पंछी को हटा. नहीं नहीं है ना, उधर ही है पंछी. I hope you guys like the video. Do share the video with someone who might benefit from it. And if this video has added any kind of value to your knowledge and to your information, then please do subscribe to When to Read What. And if you want me to make a video on a particular topic or a particular subject, then do comment it in the comment section down below. And also, you can direct message me on our Instagram handle. So, until then, happy reading!